In this video, as promised, I am going to show you database first workflow in action. So I am going to start with creating a simple table, and then I would have entity framework that generate a domain class based on that table. So let's get started. So here is my SQL Server Management Studio. Here I need to create a database first. Let's rename it database first demo and save it. As you can see, I have created my database. Now it's time to create a new table. Just store some random data. As you see, I have added some columns in my table. So now the trickiest part of database first approach came into the picture. We have this database here locally, but in order to bring a different database like a test database or a production database to this version, we need a mechanism. There are tools that are available in the market with the help of which we can compare our databases and bring them to the same version. But in my experience, they are not always reliable and can sometimes cause issues due to dependencies between tables and records. So we are going to a manual approach in which we will create a change script every time we make a change to our database. Then we need to store that change script somewhere in our repository and run them on any database to bring them to current version. So in this demo, I am going to create a change script. Let's save this table with Control S. Let's give it some meaningful name and click OK. Now the pop-up on the screen is the change script that I need to run on my machine to bring the database on the same version. There is a format to save the change script. It should be with the sequence number and a description. So I am going to save it on my machine with some meaningful name, like first is sequence, then a description. For example, create posts table dot SQL. Save it. Okay, so the table is ready. You can see it here by refreshing. See, here is our table. Great. Now jump to Visual Studio. Here the first step which we are going to do is creating a new project. Let's do it. Type of the project should be console application, and let's give it a name. Save it. Now in this new project, the first step we need to do is to install entity framework in our project. So for that, go to tools, NuGet package manager, package manager console. Here we need to run a command to install the entity framework. The command is install package entity framework with capital E and F. Hit enter. Great. The version of entity framework in my machine is 6.4.0 that you can see here. Okay. So now jump back to Solution Explorer. Just let's close it. Now jump back to Solution Explorer. Here we need to add a new item. Just click add new item. Select ADO.NET Entity Data Model. So this is going to be our conceptual model that represents the mapping between database tables and our domain classes. So I am going to give it a name as blog model, enter. And in this window, I am going to use Entity Framework Designer from database because I already have a database. Hit next. And here we need to specify a connection to our database. Click on new. We need to fetch the server name. Now select the server name. It's time to select the database. It is database first demo that we have already created. Now by clicking on test connection, we can test whether the connection is established or not. In our case, it is succeeded. Okay, click OK. Next. So at this point, Entity Framework looks good at our database and discovers the tables, views, stored procedures and functions. You can see the table posts that we had created earlier. So as of now, we just want to pull all the tables. So select it and click on the finish button. Here is our entity data model, which is stored in a file with EDMX extension. You can see the extension here. And here you see a class called post, which is exactly like the table I created earlier. Let's go to Solution Explorer. What you see here is all designer generated code. Let's expand the blog model first. And here you see blogmodel.context.tt file. Here TT stands for template. T for template. It's a way to generate code based on a template. Here you see blogmodel.context.cs file. CS is C sharp. So open it. This is the file that Entity Framework has generated for me. And you see that this class is derived from DB context. So DB context is a class that is an abstraction over the database. So it provides a simple API to load the data from or save it to the database. Now I scroll down a bit. Look, we have a property of type dbset called posts. Note that a dbset represents a table in the database. So because in our database, we have a table called posts. This is the reason in my case, we have dbset of type post called posts. Now, this post class you see here is the generated code. Now jump back to the Solution Explorer. Now it's time to move to another generated code, which is blogmodel.tt. We see post class here. Let's click on it. Interestingly, you see that this class has all the four properties that our table had earlier. So the key thing here is we started with the database, we created our table, and then we imported that into our entity data model. So every time I want to make a change in my model, I start with the database, then I come back to my EDMX file or entity data model and refresh it. So this is how workflows goes on in case of database first approach. Okay. So now let me show you how we can use a DB context to work with a database, and this applies to both on database first and code first approach. So I'm going to close all the windows here and open program.cs file. Here I'm going to create an instance of our DB context class, which is called database first model entities. Let's create it. Now I'm going to create a new post and initialize it here. Here we are done with the initialization part. Now finally, I am going to add this post to our DB set and save the changes. Context dot posts dot add the object that we have created. Now, till now, you see that the changes that we have done are still in our memory. Nothing is committed to the database yet. So let's call the context dot save changes method to save the changes permanently in our database. That's it. Run the application. Done. You see that here I didn't have to write a stored procedure. I didn't have to work with ADA.NET classes like SQL connection and SQL command. Entity framework took care of all of this for me. Now let's just verify it. Just jump back to SQL Server Management Studio. Refresh the tables. Click on the table that we had created earlier. Select top rows. Wait for a while. And here you can see the data that I just pushed during the creation of the object. You can just cross verify it again. These are the properties or sample values that I just assigned to the properties of an object and are stored in our table. So that's it from this lecture. In the upcoming video, I am going to do a demo on code first approach. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned.